Good morning. Today I have to choose the topic about the estimation of hardness of water by everyday method. How to estimate hardness of water by everyday method or complexometric method? First of all, we have to know what is meant by hardness. Mainly, actually, first we have to know that one is water. Water formula that one is H2O and water molecular weight that one is 18. Water molecular weight 18. What is the units AMU? Atomic mass unit. Water molecular formula H2O and atomic weight 18 AMU. First, what are the sources of waters? Main water sources are surface water, ground water, and rain water. The rain water is nothing but purest form of water. Remaining water, surface water and ground water, is that in that water contains some impurities. Some impurities means some salts are there. How to identify that one is that salts? For example, when soap dissolved in that water, we have to identify that water does not give any precipitate. That means it does not form any layer. That is hardness. Why that one is hardness? Hardness of water, the water contains of hardness causing salts. So now we have to discuss what are the hardness causing salts. The hardness causing salts are that one is chlorates, salts are calcium chlorides, calcium nitrate, calcium sulfate, or magnesium chloride, magnesium nitrate, or magnesium bicarbonate. That means calcium chloride, calcium sulfate, calcium nitrate and calcium bicarbonate. These are the calcium related salts. But what are the magnesium related salts? Like magnesium related salts are magnesium chloride. Next one is magnesium sulfate, calcium nitrate. Magnesium nitrate. And next one is magnesium bicarbonate. So these are the hardest causing salts. In the presence of these salts, when soap dissolved in water, due to the presence of these hardest causing salts, the water does not give any layer and it forms that one is precipitate. Okay. That is hardness of water. But how to measure hardness of waters? Some units are there. What are the units of hardness of waters? The units of hardness of water is, one is ppm. One is ppm. Next one is degree clerk. And next one is degree French or milligrams per liters. These are the units of hardness of waters. By using this unit, you have to identify that one is how much quantity of hardness causing salts present in waters. What are the relation among the these units? That one is ppm, degree of Clark, degree of French, and milligrams per liter. That means 1 ppm is equal to 1 milligrams per liter is equal to 0.07 degree clerk, and next one 0.1 degree French. These are the relation among the degree of clerk, degree of French, milligrams per liter and ppm. Okay, next. Based on removal of salt, that one is how many types of hardness of water? There are two types of hardness of water. That one is temporary hardness of water and permanent hardness of water. Temporary hardness of water and permanent hardness of water. So what are the temporary hardness? Temporary hardness means in that water consists of mainly that one is bicarbonates of calcium magnesium. That is temporary hardness of water. Next, permit or yes, permit or doubt estimate, that one is the presence of chlorides, sulfate, nitrates of calcium, magnesium. That means calcium chloride, magnesium chloride, calcium sulfate, calcium nitrate, magnesium nitrate. These are water contains of these salts. That one is mainly permanent hardness. Permanent hardness of water. Okay. In temporary hardness, how to remove temporary hardness? By boiling and filtrations. How to remove permanent hardness of waters? By ion exchange process. One is ion exchange process, and the next one is lime soda process. Explanation about hardness of waters. Now, how to estimate hardness of water? Now, we have to discuss how to estimate hardness of water. Before we have to go into the explanation about that one is estimation of hardness of water, first we have to know EDTA. What is the full form of EDTA? That one is EDTA, ethylene diamine. Tetra acetic acid. But in chemistry, chemical lab purpose, we have to using of that one is salts of that one is ethylene diamine tetra acetate. The salt means what is the structure? That one is ethylene diamine. This is the structure of ethylene diamine tetra. Salts of sodium salts of ethylene diamine tetra acetate. That is the full form. But how to estimate hardness of waters? In the estimate purpose, what are the required chemicals? The required chemicals are already known. What solution? That one is EDTA solution. One is EDTA solutions. Next one is zinc sulfate solution and buffer solution. The buffer solution means that one is a mixture of that one is weak acid and then salts. Weak acid means that one is ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. It is the buffer, and we have to use that one is erythrome black tea indicators. So these are the required chemicals to estimate total hardness of water by EDTA method. Next one, what are the required operators are beaker, and next one is burette, and measuring cylinder and pipette. So pipette, these are the required operators. Now we have to know that one is how to prepare the solution. First, we have to prepare that one is preparation of which solution? That one is zinc sulfate solution. Preparation of zinc sulfate solutions. So, how to prepare zinc sulfate solutions? We have to make that one is 0.3 grams of zinc sulfate solid compound in dissolving 100 ml of that one is 100 ml of distilled waters. 100 ml of distilled waters. That one is how to find the molarity formula is equal to weight by gram molecular weight into 1000 by VML. VML means we have to take that one is 100 ml. By substituting that one is weight of the compound 0.3 and gram molecular weight 289.84 and finally you will get that one is molecular weight 0.1 molar. Molecular zinc sulfate solutions. Next step, first step that one is preparation of zinc sulfate solutions and the second step that one is standardization of EDTA solutions. The standardization means now to find that one is molarity of EDTA solutions. How to find out molarity of solution? So first of all, in conical flask, we have to take that one is 20 ml of zinc sulfate solution and add 5 ml of buffer solution, 5 ml of buffer solutions and 2-3 drops of erythrome black tea indicators, 2-3 drops of erythrome black tea indicators. In conical flask, we have to observe that one is color change, that one is wine red colors. First add in conical flask 20 ml of sulfate solutions and 5 ml of buffer solution, 2-3 drops of that one is GPT indicator. We have to identify that one is wine red color solution. In burette, you have to take that one is EDTA solution. But how to standardize that one is EDTA solution? In conical flask, you have to take the solution. In burette, you have to take the zinc sulfate solution. After titrating, finally you have to find out that one is blue color. That means wine red color changes into blue color. But what is the principle involved in these equations? Mainly that one is EDTA, actually hardest kind of salt. Standardization of EDTA method, by using the EDTA method we have to find out that one is molarity of that one is EDTA solution. EDTA solution means EDTA and zinc sulfate solutions. M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. While titrating, we have to know that one is already molarity in preparations. We have to find out that one is molarity of zinc sulfate solutions. And next one is volume of zinc sulfate solution in conical flask. We have to take that one is 20 ml of zinc sulfate solution. Next one is volume of EDTA. Volume of EDTA means the color change. While adding up solution from the burette, we have to identify the color change. That one is burette reading. We have to find out that one is burette reading. By burette reading substituted in this formula, we get that one is EDTA. EDTA is equal to molarity. M1 V1 is equal to M2 V2. Okay? By drawing that one is table, we have to find out in table or column. First, I will draw that table. Serial number, and volume of zinc sulfate solution. Next one is burette reading, initial reading, final reading. Next volume of EDTA. Okay, we have to take 20 ml of zinc sulfate solution. First initially you have to take the burette reading 0. Wine red color changes into blue color. We have to find out that one is burette reading. Okay, next one. This is the first trial and second trial again you have to take 0 burette reading and finally you have to note down that burette reading. Note down in these three trials we have to take that one is concrete value. The concrete value is nothing but that one is volume of EDTA. By using this value we have to substitute in this formula. We have to substitute in the formula M base EDTA, volume of base EDTA. Next one is M base, that one is zinc sulfate solution, and volume base zinc sulfate solution. Substitute in these equations, we have to find out that one is molarity of EDTA. This is a process of standardization of that one is EDTA. Next one is estimation of hardness of water. How to estimate that one is hardness of water? Next one, estimation of hardness of water. Estimation of total hardness. Hardness of water. Estimation of total hardness of estimation of total hardness of water. Estimation of okay. I will take that on next class. Okay, next part I will explain. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.